You know, some viewers may be watching us and thinking, huh, the boys are standing on a very accurate set of the White House library.
But they'd be wrong.
Indeed, they would be, because this is not a set. This is the real deal, because on today's special episode of MythBusters, the myth we're busting comes courtesy of a very special guest.
In fact, here he is.
Hey, guys. How are you?
Very good.
Good to see you. Welcome to the White House.
Thank you, Mr. President.
It is a thrill to have you here.
So what can we do for you?
Well, I am a big fan of MythBusters.
Really?
I am, and so are the girls. Partly because we are just fascinated by science. You guys make it fun and exciting and interesting, and occasionally you blow things up, which is always cool. But I have a personal interest in this as president because nothing's more important to our country's future than getting young people engaged in math and science. A lot of the challenges that we face as a country are going to depend on how engaged young people are in science, and so I'm just thrilled that you guys do such a great job making it fun.
Thank you, sir. That means a great deal to us.
Well, I appreciate that. Now, I do know that science requires a lot of trial and error. Part of what MythBusters is about is testing out various hypotheses, and I think that we've got a big one that hasn't been thoroughly tested.
Which one is that?
Well, it is Archimedes' solar ray.
Well, that is a classic.
It is a classic, and so I'm hoping that we can take one more crack at it.
Okay.
The story goes that Archimedes designed a solar weapon that focused the sun's rays with such ferocity, it set an invading Roman navy ablaze. But when the MythBusters duplicated his ancient design,
it's 280 degrees!
It failed to fuel a fire.
I'm standing right in it, and I'm not dead yet.
So they reloaded the ray with the help of MIT and 300 mirrors.
Look at that!
But that still didn't set this myth alight.
I see a little smoke, but I've seen worse than that before.
Which leaves Adam with a burning question.
If you don't mind me saying so, sir, what do you think we actually got wrong on this?
Well, there's one thing you didn't do.
Well, we did use a giant solar mirror array.
And we did use 300 bronze mirrors on shelving units that were aimable.
True.
But we didn't use, what, manpower?
Exactly.
Ah, and the Greeks had plenty of access to manpower, so if we could get a whole bunch of people, like 500 people each with their own mirror, we might just be able to test this.
So how do you want us to do that?
Well, I'm going to leave that up to you guys. You're the experts. I'm going to stay here in Washington. I've got a little bit of business to attend to, but I expect you guys to go back to San Francisco, figure this out, get to the bottom of this once and for all, and then report back to me.
We're on it.
All right, soldiers, you're doing a fantastic job. I'd like everyone to take their mirrors off the target briefly and take a deep breath with me. Inhale. Exhale. On the count of three, I want you all to aim your beams at that black sun and keep them as steady as possible. Are you ready? We are doing this for Syracuse. In 3, 2, 1, aim on that black sun. Hold it steady. Find your beam, keep it centered on that sail. That's it, that's twice as bright as before.
Twice as bright, but to ignite the sail, that focal point will have to reach 410 degrees Fahrenheit. And with the black sun at 230 degrees, that's a long way off.
Look, he's taunting you! We are giving this every possible effort. This is the last chance we have to catch this thing on fire. Oh! Oh no, he's lobbing flaming tennis balls at us! Keep those mirrors on the sail! Ooh, he just took out one of your great cameramen! Are you gonna stand for that? Keep those mirrors focused on the sail!
The tennis balls are flying, and the beams are focused on the sail. But while 280 degrees is impressive, it's still 130 degrees off of what's needed for sail ignition.
Okay, Adam, I figure that if this is a real war, you just lost, because I got a whole bunch of you guys, and you didn't get one of me.
I think you're right. Why don't you gear down and come on in? I think we got to call this one.
Yeah.